7:53 Central Time tonight. The state of Alabama started carrying out the execution of Kenneth Eugene Smith by nitrogen hypoxia at the William C. Holman Correctional Facility in Smith was executed for the 1988 capital murder of Elizabeth Dorleen Sennett in Colbert County. Please confer with the media witnesses for Smith's last words. Smith was pronounced deceased by physicians at 8:25 p.m. Central Standard Time. The victim's family will certainly address the media here in a minute. But I wanted to go ahead and open it up for questions for y'all. Ms. Kim.
Okay. Commissioner, Mr. Smith appeared to shake and writhe on the gurney for at least 2 minutes at the start of the execution. Was that expected, and what do you think that meant? Was that suffering in your view?
Ms. Kim, appeared that one, Smith was holding his breath as long as he could, and then there's also information out there he struggled against his restraints a little bit, but there's some involuntary movement and some agonal breathing. So that was all expected and is in the side effects that we've seen or researched on nitrogen hypoxia. So nothing was out of the ordinary what we were expecting.
You think it was involuntary?
Yes. Yes, Your Honor.
After the Supreme Court allowed the execution to go forward and media witnesses were transferred over, we waited for about 45 minutes before we were taken into the chamber. What was the delay there?
The delay we had was hooking, well, not hooking up, but the EKG lines, where we were making sure we got a good reading on those. There was a little hiccup on the EKG lines providing a good reading. So that's... That was the for the delay to make sure we got a good reading.
Was the hiccup due to him cooperating, not cooperating?
Oh yeah, there was no information that he was not cooperating with that.
Can you say approximately how long the nitrogen was flowing?
I think it was around 15 minutes. I have to get some precise times on that, but it seemed about 15 minutes, and y'all have seen our redacted protocol on the two time frames, either 15 minutes or 5 minutes past flat line. So we were within those protocols.
He appeared conscious for the first several minutes. Do you agree with that? The Attorney General's office in court filings said they thought that nitrogen would cause a lack of consciousness within seconds.
I don't know. I couldn't really see his face from where I was sitting. Y'all might have had a better view of that.
Any plans to implement this method for future inmates on death row?
That's not our, this is the state law for the state of Alabama that nitrogen hypoxia is one of the three methods of execution. So if the inmates choose it, then that's the method we will use. So it's not whether we're implementing or not, it's the state law of Alabama. So right now,
how did y'all test nitrogen hypoxia before this execution? How did y'all test
So
it?
Right now I would like,
you can't answer that?
The victim's family to come make a statement.
Good evening. Some of you that have talked with us today and through the week, some of this may be a little repetitive, but to my left is my wife, Kim. My name's Mike Sennett. I have my brother, Chuck, his wife, Pam, here, and others, friends. We want to take a minute to thank everybody that has supported us through this time. Friends, family members, and others, thank you very much for the prayers, comments, texts, and so forth. We want to give a special shout out to a few people. Ronnie May, the former sheriff of Colbert County, was on the case from the beginning, and they did a great job. We want to thank Abby and Dasha from NBC Now. They were the first to contact us about this story, and we kept with just one national news media, and they were the ones that we went with, and they did a fabulous job. Super nice. So thank you for that. Nothing happened here today is gonna bring mom back. Nothing. It's kind of a bittersweet day. We're not gonna be jumping around, hooping and hollering, hooray and all that. That's not us. But we're glad this day is over. All three of the people involved in this case years ago, we have forgiven them. Not today, but we have in the past. Some people may not believe that. You know, how do you forgive somebody? Well, if we're to be more Christ-like, try to live his teachings and stuff, he forgave the ones on the cross, right? The thieves. And if I'm trying to live my life like him, it's my duty and it's weight off my shoulders. I forgive them. I forgive them for what they done. I don't like what they done from us. You know, the Bible says that evil deeds has consequences. And Kenneth Smith made some bad decisions 35 years ago. And his debt was paid tonight. Some of you may have heard us talk about, you know, over and over about 35 years. Kenneth Smith, Parker, Williams not so much because he died in the system, I think in 2020, something like that. But Parker and Smith have been incarcerated almost twice as long as I knew my mom. Think about that a minute. I guess I'll end by saying that Elizabeth Dorleen Thorn Senate got her justice tonight. Thank you.
Presser, I'll give y'all a good hour to get with the pool media witnesses and get their information and wrap up your articles and your stories, and then we'll close the media center. Thank you. All right, everybody ready for, yeah, everybody good?
All right, this is the pool media report that the five media witnesses that were inside of the chamber compiled. We have all compiled this together, so you can attribute it however needed. All right, my name is Ivana. I work for yale.com. For those of you who don't know me. The curtain opened at 7:53 p.m. to the viewing room. Curtain closed at 8:15 p.m. Kenneth Smith made a lengthy final statement. It began with tonight Alabama caused humanity to take a step backward. He continued saying, I'm leaving with love, peace, and light. Thank you for supporting me. Love all of you. There were other parts of his final statement that media was not able to dictate because it was lengthy. Kenneth Smith also made a I love you sign in sign language with one of his hands that was facing the room where his family was witnessing along with media witnesses. He appeared conscious for several minutes into the execution. For about 2 minutes following that, Kenneth Smith shook and writhed for about 2 minutes on a gurney. That was followed by several minutes of deep breaths on the gurney. Following that, his breath slowed until it was no longer perceptible for media witnesses. The governor's office pronounced the time of death at 8:25. And again, the curtains closed to that room at 8:15 p.m. Thank y'all.
I'm sure we did. Thank you. Yeah, thank you all.
I'd rather not that. It's real hard.
I mean, this is just a camera.